What made her this way? What is the attraction? What keeps us fascinated? This is the story of Christian. On November 30th, 2015, Christine posted a photo of her bed on Facebook, commenting that a small part of the bedsheet sticking out appeared to look like a white cat, and found it amusing. On December 1st, she revealed that she would soon be selling customized Amiibo figurines depicting a Sunny and a Rosie, made from leftover tailless Pikachu Amiibos, whose tails were used in the creation of Chris's Sonichu figures. The following day, she notified her Facebook followers that she was not feeling well due to excessive sleep, dizziness, blankness, and off-centeredness. In the comments, she elaborated that she felt as if she were quote-unquote tripping, though she was not under any high-inducing drugs. Chris thought that her feelings were due to stress. Also on that day, she updated her followers via a YouTube video about her embargo against the local GameStops and other retailers from which she had been banned.
Hello everyone! Slight update to the plan there. In addition to the embargo against the GameStop, Best Buy, and Simon Malls, we need to make sure that GameStop is well aware of this. And I'm not sure this is getting to the 1-4 stores address. So we need to go onto Facebook, look up the GameStop page, and message them, as well as posting onto their timeline, letting them know that this injustice must be undone, that I should be unbanned. Thank you.
She later revealed that she posted the video onto GameStop's official Facebook page, but it was soon removed. Chris interpreted this action as being ignored, and so encouraged her followers to spam share the video concerning her embargo to GameStop, because she felt that the game retailer was being unfair to autistic people and the LGBTQ community. On December 4th, Christine claimed over Facebook that after a week of placing vibrating eggs, usually meant for sexual stimulation, inside her bra and onto her breasts had naturally enlarged, and recommended this method coupled with some natural or RX estrogens. She later posted a video showing how she achieved growth with the help of vibrating eggs and estrogel, a topical estrogen cream usually used to treat symptoms of menopause, after being inspired by another YouTube user's progress using the same technology.
I'm gonna show off among the way of transitioning and being a transgender person, trans woman. I'd apply some estrogel. It goes, you rub it down here, usually all over. The tubes, it comes with a spatula. It's got little grooves on right there. One end to the other. That's the amount of space you want to put for the mount. So, you know, I mark it with mark the inside end of my thumb and go from one end of the groove to the other. But yeah, after you get down there, I mean, you just rub it on there like butter on bread. No big deal. You do this once a night for up to 24 to 28 days out of the month, and then you take the 3 to 7 day break for the remaining days up until where you start up the routine again for the following month. And then on the second thing, I have actually confirmed plausible. The vibrating brassiere, or at least what I did, I took a couple of remote control vibrating eggs. I tend to keep my shirt on, so I slip them about one right there, one there, and then I just turn them both on full blast. And I like to let that go on for about 15 to 30 minutes a day. And I have found that after the first week of trying this, I have found a significant increase in my bust size. A little bit better than D, I'm sure, but I haven't used a measuring tape yet. But I have Yeah, I have seen the difference in my shadow on the wall and just looking down upon them. So even if it doesn't work out, just it feels good, the vibrations there. Thank you very much, and have a good day.
On December 7th, Christine received a letter purported to be from Russ Rogerson, the corporate safety and loss prevention representative for GameStop, who informed her that instead of unbanning her from the four local GameStop establishments, he felt it more appropriate that she be banned from all the GameStops in the state of Virginia due to her continuous threats against the company. After some thorough analysis and research, members of the Kiwi Farms determined that the letter was most likely faked by a troll. Believing its veracity, Chris responded to it in a YouTube video posted later that day.
Good evening, fans. Apparently we finally have received a response from GameStop, but I just would like to go on record that if it turned out to be a prank from somebody in the mailroom of GameStop, possibly at the very least, then you need to tell me directly and what the deal is, because certainly being tired of being ignored.
Chris then recites the letter in its entirety.
And essentially, the list has me banned from statewide. Everywhere in Virginia, all the GameStops in Virginia, essentially. Which, that just really pissed me off. Really pisses me off. But I did not mean anything threatening in my letter. Their interpretation was quite off. We need to step it up. Everybody! Go to your local GameStops and bring up a sign of your own, and write on that "quote unquote" GameStop. Bloody unfair to autistic people and lesbians, gays, bisexuals, transsexuals, and queer people. This will certainly be forwarded to the Human Rights Campaign, Autism Awareness, and the Better Business Bureau, among all places. Oh. And just to note, to take this to counter their attack, I have found and learned of a few other flaws in their plan, of which I am to quote, I have them written down, among which they apparently have banned a lot of people! Lots of people! With hardly a reason, other than I don't know, Lord knows what. What is the bloody past memory in those people in that corporate office to turn them into such cruel, soulless, heartless, bleeding bastards? And among which, you know what they do to every last video game used or otherwise possibly new that they cannot sell? You know what they do? I have a mallet in my hand. This is a NES game of Super Mario Bros. Duck Hunt. Pew! Smash it! They destroyed those games! All my vintage brethren. Vintage gaming brethren. You want to see those vintage games once again. You don't want GameStop to destroy them. We must protest! Cancel any pre-orders! And certainly, do not use their online resources for further purchases. And if I am imitating any accent, it is quite accidental and coincidental. But I mean it. They destroyed all the unsold games. Downright. Very bad, bloody bastards. Heartless, soulless, we stand amongst them, not only to get me unbanned statewide and everywhere, but to make them not so discriminative. Unfair to everybody, GameStop is. Oh,
the Amiibo figures. Guess what? There's still Toys R Us. There's still Walmart. There's still Target. And guess what? $10 a piece or so for the Sonics and the Pikachu, among which there is eBay and Amazon. So, I am not haltered on my own creations, and henceforth, so the orders on Etsy will continue to be honored, very much so. Thank you very much. Have a good and safe day. And down with GameStop!
The next day, Christine posted on Facebook that she had been watching British TV shows such as Doctor Who, keeping up appearances, and as time goes by, prompting Kiwi Farms members to deduce that this was the source of a recently morphing accent. On December 13th, Chris posted a video on YouTube wishing her followers a happy holiday season.
Hello everybody, it's Christine Chandler coming to you live from home again. Here's my cat, Lucy. Lucy is a pretty cat. Apparently Bolo is an outside cat, so he's out by the gazebo right now. Anyway, I'm making this video today to wish y'all a happy holiday, and as under advisement, I'm making their suggestions of what y'all can do for me for gifts. I'll look into it. I'll make a short wish list on Amazon.com, but I also accept gift cards to, well, let's say for Walmart, Target, Food Lion, Toys R Us will be okay. Family Dollar, PetSmart, whatever. Anyway, we're okay. But cash should be greatly appreciated. I'll remind everybody of the donation listing on my shop on Etsy. I'll put a link under this video. So hopefully I'll get another big donation this time around, because I sure could, among which, use that money to help pay the bills around here. Plus also, yeah, I do have a court cost to pay after the incident near the end of last year, but that's a whole different story anyway. So anyway, once again, I want to wish everybody a happy, safe holiday, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, be safe. Especially when if y'all are traveling to go be with your family, or maybe even to adopt a new pet from the animal shelters. Yeah. I wonder how many children are getting new kitties and puppies and fishes this year. Yeah, I thought they'll be happy. Yeah. Now my little Lucy. Does Lucy love me too? Yeah. Oh, you wanna get down? I'll let you go. Have a good, safe day. Thank you.
She then made a wish list on the merchant site, Amazon.com, consisting of 53 items which could be bought by other people and sent to her as a gift. The list largely featured DVD box sets of British TV shows, collections of the cartoon series Peanuts on VHS, and notably, a Megatron Transformers figure costing $210. 2 days later, Chris uploaded another video featuring her dancing to the song Sensual Seduction by rapper Snoop Dogg. The reason for the production of this video is uncertain. I'm gonna take my time. She gonna get hers before I'm gonna take it slow. I'm not gonna rush the stroll, so she can get a sensual seduction. So I can get a sensual seduction. Just a few hours later, she uploaded another video in which she performs her own original parody of the Christmas song, 12 Days of Christmas.
Season's greetings and happy holidays, everybody. And come bearing a variation of a Christmas classic, the 12 Days of Christmas. But we'll skip the repetition and somebody else can put the singing parts with the tune. And so with that, on with the list. On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me the instant classic, the Japanese transistor radio. On the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me the numerical alphabet. It looked like the number 2. But guess what? That is a capital Q in cursive. 2 to Q. And with the unanimous decision in my own mental head, 2 is officially a letter. And not only that, but between the 2 and the 5, you also get S and Z. And skip to the roundabout in the alphabet. 0 is an O, 1 an I, and an L. With the common link to number 7, that's also an L, but the number 7, with or without the cross, can still be the capital F. With that nonsense out of the way, on the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me free, fresh fish. I've got a fish, would you like to make a wish? You got yourself a fish? Now order a new side dish. Make a wish.
Chris continued to list what presents she received on each of the 12 days of Christmas, mostly told in her style of random access humor.
And on the 10th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 10 million yen and a big fat hen. 10 million yen and a big fat hen. 10 million yen and a big fat hen. A big fat hen. I might have more redone holiday hits in the next few days before Christmas of 2015. But that's still to be determined. Donations are still greatly appreciated, and I still welcome more orders, figures, and everything. And up until Christmas Day, donations of $100 or greater get one additional figure of their choice, though I can't guarantee before Christmas delivery. Thank you. Have a good, safe day. Merry Christmas.
On December 18th, Christine uploaded another video in which she sings her own parodic take of the Christmas song, Jingle Bells.
Dashing through the trees, pumping vine to vine, over the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on raindrops on leaves ring, making spirits bright. Oh, what fun it is to laugh and sing a swinging song tonight. Oh, jungle bells, Tarzan smells, Georgia, the jungle, swinging through the forest, vine to vine. Watch out for that tree, wham! Jungle bells, Tarzan smells, Georgia, the jungle, swinging through the forest, vine to vine. Watch out for that tree. Phew! Donations still appreciated very much, and continue ordering. Thank you. Have a good day.
On that same day, she uploaded a video in which she is seen outside, playing around with a soccer ball. Even though the video was originally uploaded as unlisted, meaning that only people who possessed its URL link could view it, it was still leaked onto the Kiwi Farms. On December 21st, Chris posted on Facebook that upon checking her Amazon wishlist again, she discovered that all of the items she wanted others to buy for her had disappeared, thinking that all were bought by her fans and would eventually be delivered to her. She said that if she received more than one PlayStation 4 game console and camera, Chris would donate one to a children's charity. In addition, she further encouraged donations through her online store on Etsy. She later added a comment in which she asked for a pretty blue or red dress, and listed off her measurements. All of her gift requests were in fact removed from her wishlist by low-effort trolls, or weens, by simply clicking on the Buying This Gift Elsewhere option on each item. She later felt that the reason for the removals was that she needed to add additional details, and so decided to remake her list again. On the 22nd, Christine added a new category on her Etsy store, personalized video recordings of holiday greetings to anyone who donated $50. She also advertised the offer in video form.
Hello, once again, Merry Christmas and all that rot. So we're born live to my home again, and yeah, I got a little Christmas tree. And my mom and I, we decorated it recently. So that's delightful. Anyway, I'm making this video to inform everyone that up until the end of December 24th, with the $50 donation, I'll do a video request and shout out holiday greeting to anybody y'all might request. So it's like, you know, here's a free sample. So here's a sample. Hello, Jane Doe, what you know? We're gonna have a holiday show. Santa coming around on the treetop tonight. Merry Christmas and happy holidays. So it's as simple as that. And also, another thing I had on my mind. Okay, well, yeah, in lack of having completed some versions of the song lyrics I parody with, so it's like you could do this. Da 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 da. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with lovely weather. Somebody could put that on the track and make it like I'm singing. That one little line where it's a lovely weather.
She then references a video from the popular YouTube channel College Humor, in which entrepreneurial billionaire Donald Trump is mocked and reimagined as the Christmas character, the Grinch, for his recently launched campaign for the presidency of the United States.
Oh, but I did enjoy from College Humor recently. You're a mean one, Mr. Trump. You really ought to take a dump. Nobody likes you regardless of all that money, Mr. Trump. Given a choice between the three of you, the Trump, the Grinch, and the seasick crocodile, I'd still stick with the seasick crocodile. You, sorry, Trump, I'm not voting for you, and I don't think anybody else will either.
On Christmas Day, she published her first holiday greeting on YouTube, dedicated to a Kiwi Farms member who had merely suggested to Chris that a sample greeting could drive up sales, but did not donate anything for the video effort.
Here is a special Christmas dedication to Karen Riley. Hello, Karen. You're looking fine. I saw your picture, and I do this video just for you. Didn't owe me a dime? Da, 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 da. I don't know, I got Camptown Ladies stuck in my head right now. Oh well, let's do a song. Jungle bells, Tarzan smells, Georgia the jungle, swinging through the forest, fine to fine, watch out for that tree. Woo! But special holiday greetings to you, Karen. Hope you have a happy and safe one. May you get everything that you want. Thank you very much.
On December 26th, Christine posted an unfortunate update on Facebook. Update and announcement! I hesitated to inform everyone, but Lulu has suspended my account on their website because they considered my work fanfiction and were concerned on the copyright and all that sh**. This has been on for a couple of weeks. The last number of Number Zero books I've shipped out over a week ago were the last I have been able to ship out, available to me. I have talked with the people of Lulu, and they are unreasonable and won't listen. Ugh! I'm working on finding another good publishing site and updating my book files along the way. Currently, I'm looking into publishing through CreateSpace and Amazon piggybacking on that. This has been a lot of headaches and stress upon me. As soon as possible, I will be able to catch up on the book orders. Meanwhile, I sincerely apologize for the delay, and I appreciate everyone's patience in this dilemma. I hate #lulu.com for making me have to go through all of this worse stress and mental torture. The following day, she posted about a dream she had. I just woke up from a dream. I remembered a couple of fun things. Marty McFly was telling me I swallowed a strangler. I asked, how did he do that? He said, I stood there, looking at the strangler, and I swallowed. The other thing was just a random thing. A woman said to her friend, you know who would be good in any musical? Irving Berlin. Have some more Z's to catch. Good night. On December 29th, Chris posted that she was feeling troubled over Lulu's removal of her Sonnet U comics, and that she was still searching for alternative publishers. For those who had ordered a book, she wrote that she could not provide refunds, as she had bills to pay, and offered to send the buyers medallions or figurines instead of the books, with the prices of which reduced by the prices of the comics. Shortly after, Chris wrote another related post. I feel like asking if someone would go to Lulu.com's building and punching the executives there for causing all of this distress and upset upon me. Merp slurp me wop filkin gee duop he cho. Her trollsome gal pal, Kim Wilson, commented that it would be illegal if customers requested a refund and she refused to give them one. Her other Facebook friend, Kenneth Engelhart, stated that a workaround could be to make a new version of the Sonnet U comics, with all the copyright infringing content removed and or replaced, and offering that for purchase in its stead, while offering the original version for free. In a private conversation with Kiwi Farms member, Pickle Inspector, Christine elaborated that she wanted someone to find the head office and punch an executive into caring about her plight. However, she didn't mean that literally, because she was not thinking clearly, but felt like she would want to do that if she could. Chris further updated that she was feeling headaches, stresses, and was dizzy, out of focus, and hurt. Kim felt that her feelings were a symptom of being overweight, and recommended that Christine try to exercise more to get into shape. Kim further elaborated that she was not being insulting, but rather was expressing her concern over Chris's health problems, adding that the dizziness could also be a side effect of her excessive use of estrogel. On New Year's Eve, Christine wished her Facebook followers a Happy New Year, informing them that since she was still feeling woozy from recent stress, she was having a rest, and again noted that donations would be greatly appreciated. On January 1st, 2016, Christine posted gibberish on Facebook, asking if that were acceptable, since her mind was full of it lately, and in closing, wished everyone a slappy new year. Later that day, she updated her video greeting option on Etsy to extend to birthdays, holidays, and other general greeting occasions. She revealed in the listing photographs that she had made several holiday greetings for customers, which were still on her YouTube channel for assumed anonymous buyers, unlisted, and thusly unviewable to the wider public. In the description, Chris explained that the privacy status of the commissioned videos could be specified by the customers. On the 3rd, she asked if there were any developments in her protest against GameStop, linking to a YouTube video from user Master Cozy Fighter, featuring several Oweens in front of a GameStop, pretending to protest on Christine's behalf.
GameStop! It's bloody unfair! GameStop! It's bloody unfair! GameSpot! GameStop! It's bloody unfair! GameStop! It's bloody unfair!
Are they biased towards you?
They're biased against me, because I'm autistic. You know a man named Christine Weston Chandler? They have banned him from all GameStops in the country, purely because he may...
On January 6th, Chris made a YouTube video hoping to attract contenders for a proposed lesbian slumber party at her house.
Hello ladies, once again, Christine Chandler coming to you live from home. With a cat. I'm a cat and I have two cats. But that's not why I'm making this video. I am making this video because I would like to let y'all know about the lesbian slumber party that I am planning on. The date has not been set yet, but I am extending the invitations. So, let me know that you would like to attend today to my name Christine email address listed below this video, and we can have a night of fun and frivolous activities, and the application is open to all straight, lesbian, and bisexual women. So come on out and we'll have a sexy time. Thank you very much.
She also shared the video over Facebook, noting that an unknown gal friend would be co-hosting the event. She asked for willing applicants to apply via an email with proof of identity and self-photo attached to her anightinchristine@gmail.com email address, which was in fact administrated by another unknown party without any input from Chris. Kenneth Engelhart commented that Christine was supposed to be tending to her elderly, vulnerable mother and advised against advertising for strangers to come to her house. Also on that day, Chris shared another video from the same Weens who had previously made the fake GameStop protest video, this time allegedly protesting against Lulu's mistreatment of Chris's comics.
Lulu, it's bloody unfair. Thank you. Sonichu forever. Sonichu will never die.
Come on, Noel. Shut that shit the fuck up.
Let me tell you about someone named Christine Weston Chandler, okay?
Come on, Noel. Shut the fuck
Lulu
up,
Lulu is bloody unfair.
Shut the fuck
Lulu
up,
Lulu's bloody unfair.
On January 7th, Christine claimed to be making her move in finding another publisher for her comic books, updating her listing on the Etsy store to include a bundle featuring the first three issues of Sonichu, and promised to complete all the orders she had received in December. She also hinted that she would attend the upcoming gaming and anime convention, OmegaCon, and could autograph copies of her books if fans brought them along. She later revealed in a private message that she was offered a booth at the next OmegaCon, which would allow her to autograph her books for fans. Kiwi Farms user BMO later revealed themselves to have been in contact with Christine, and since they were possibly a member of the convention staff, were aiming to feature Chris in a presentation and discussion panel in front of an audience at the convention concerning Sonichu and Chris's infamy. Despite what Chris had told to a different individual, she would not be given a free table and the chance to sell her comics at the convention center due to copyright concerns. On January 9th, Kiwi Farms member Reshiram sent an email to Chris's Uniting Christine email address purporting to be a male-to-female transgender lesbian looking to find friends in the Charlottesville area, with special interest in meeting Chris because of her lesbian slumber party video. The anonymous person controlling the email wrote back pretending to be Christine, stating that only natural-born women were allowed to come to her home. Reshiram posted their correspondence on the forums under the belief that it was Chris who had replied, even though Marvin cast some doubt upon her reply. Shortly after, Chris removed her YouTube video concerning the lesbian slumber party and posted an update about it and her merchandise business in a video uploaded on January 11th.
Anywho, I'm making this update to make a couple of brief announcements. The video invitation has been taken down. I have received every sign to keep the eventual party between friends only. And I have sent out a lot of books today. A lot of books. So I just completed all the orders. So your coupon codes for all y'all past customers. Yeah. You'll be receiving your books, definitely, within the next couple of weeks. And still would like some more business, appreciate that. Still can make more figures, and I have to just a little bit more to catch up on. I'll be updated. I'll be doing that this week, but I would appreciate more business, because, well, we need the money around here, among which, that's for sure. Yeah. So anyway, it's just the update for now. Thank you all for your continued patronage and support and everything. Have a great and safe day.
The next day, Chris made another video after finding out that Jeff / Francine, the troll who claimed to have been stealing her identity and selling fake merchandise, was also planning to host a lesbian slumber party, according to a fake promotional poster Francine made to advertise the event.
Hello everybody, good evening. I'm in a bit of a mood right now, not to upset my current business inputs and whatnot, but I want to make one thing perfectly clear. With the individual who's my gray between male to female, Jeff / Francine Ozos over in Seattle, Washington, his infringement on the use of my Sonichu character is still being under quite debate. He is infringing on my Sonichu rights as well, including as stated in his invitations to his upcoming party, claiming of a quote-unquote new Sonichu Amiibo figure. He's totally infringing. Jeff Ozos, Francine Ozos, needs to be taken down. He, she still needs to pay the royalties to me very much. And
Do not go to his her party whatsoever. That's about it. Thank you. Have a good, safe day and night.
On January 13th, Chris updated her Sonichu comic listings on her Etsy page using the site kablam.com as her new publisher. 4 days later, she made another video complaining about Francine's slumber party.
I'm retracting my previous engagement in the video and I hereby announce that you should totally go to Jeff's party. It could be so off the hook. I mean, it's totally not a bullshit imitation of my party. Bullshit imitation. Like, mine would be so much better. Or like, his would be much better than I. No difference. Oh yeah, and Jeff is totally a super nice gal and all. He's not a total asshole. So, contact Mistress Jeff if you want more details on going to her party. Yeah. Totally off the haps and off the ropes and everything. That's about it for right now. Thank you, everybody. Have a good, safe day. Thank you.
Chris also sarcastically advertised the event and video over Facebook, encouraging others to attend Francine's party. On January 21st, Christine posted some news regarding the troll Francine. It has come to my attention that Jeff Ozos is set to serve time in prison. Suffice to say that among which, his shop on Zazzle.com, along with his other shops, will not be able to fulfill any orders for a very long time. During his remaining free time, I pray he is able to make such online amends. I most sincerely feel sorry for her outcome in life. At least now I can retract my recent passive-aggressive promotions of her party. I really did not want to promote anything of hers at all. I had to this time because, stubborn SOB she was, she refused to pay me the retro royalties from the use of my characters and self-image on her shops. And since it is moot now, I can finally state how upset I have felt about her and why. Among which, her continuing pretentious, egocentric, selfish, greedy, delusional attitude and behavior really closed the deal. Especially after I doxed her in the earlier video, she had communicated with me her feelings of regret and sadness and desire to make amends. Alas, shortly after, nothing had changed in her attitude and behavior. In private chats with my new lady friend, Jeff interrupted and really butted in and tried to prove herself better than I. I had remained as cool as possible, regardless of the anxiety and stress Jeff's intrusions have caused unto me and my friend. To put it most blunt, Jeff is no better than the egocentric, self-centered, narcissistic, sociopathic, probably psychopathic, sexist, probably paranoid, insecure, unable to maintain having learned anything from past misdeeds and errors, Looney Tune, Daffy Duck. Not to mention that she also continues to panhandle, using my name to get sex and online money and misdirected fame, even regardless of having just got a home for herself. I had offered an olive branch of friendship and kindness after Jeff communicated her regrets after the doxing, but then I felt need to retract it after she resumed her malsocial behavior and attitude shortly after. I had informed Jeff that she and I were not friends after she showed her bad ass to my face, but she disillusioned and misperceived continuing friendship between her and I. She really had disappointed me. I was concerned over all this going against her and her past misdeeds catching up eventually in hopes of trying to make her understand and improve herself mentally and emotionally in maturity. I was mistaken. I want to thank Jeff for her support and interest in my works and creations over the years. It offended and disappoints me that she had used my name for sex and misplaced money and fame upon herself though. On the 22nd, she advertised her custom Amiibo and Lego figurines available from her store in a YouTube video.
Christine Chandler coming to you live with another update. Oh, calm down, Lucy. I'm making a video right now. Kitty, kitty. I love you. Okay, calm down, Lucy. I'll talk to you later. Anyway, I have a few more figures that I'm going to be putting on the shop layer today. Yeah, and I made this nice, lovely little carrying case between combining the Technic slotted Amiibo bricks and a bunch of Technic bricks. It works pretty good for carrying around the whole lot. Also, something else that I'm considering adding to my shop, I'll give y'all an opportunity to purchase my own custom minifigure. Whether you want the past or the present versions of me. Thinking about it further on the little minifigures, I might do $10 plus shipping per figure. And I don't know, maybe an extra $2 or $5 for the base. I have to check on eBay or wherever for the price of just the base. Anyway, aside from that, definitely need some more money coming in. We're coming a bit short on the whatever this month. Yeah, but anyway, we're doing okay, mostly. And we got a big snowstorm coming in, expected this weekend, so that definitely gave me time to put together any new orders that come about recently and today. Alright, so, link to the shop is underneath this video. Oh, one more note I will add, which I have commented about recently on Facebook. I would like to extend my most formal, vocal, and emotional apologies to Jeff, whose fate has pretty much become unfortunate. I do feel sorry for her very much. So, just a moment of silence right here. And I do thank her for her loyal support and interest for everything Sancho and Rose Chew and myself that I've been making since 2007. Okay. Thank you very much and have a good day.
With the seeming demise of her latest foe, Chris apparently avoided a larger trolling saga. Yet hiding behind the scenes was a mysterious gal friend about which nothing was revealed. Once again, Christine was in the midst of a possibly new acquaintanceship with a troll, pretending to be a possible love interest, unbeknownst to Chris, and also to the ones who watched her the closest.